Thank you. Mrs. Willmott.
Thank you, President. I'm happy to have voted for this report as it gives us the opportunity to make sure that greater emphasis is put on social and environmental standards when Member States reward contracts under public procurement rules. In my constituency of the East Midlands, the UK Government has recently chosen to award a major train building contract to the lowest cost supplier, using the procurement rules to justify this. The decision means that 1,400 people at the Bombardier site in my constituency will become redundant. Indirectly, many thousands more will lose their jobs. It is a clear illustration of why the directive needs reform. We want all procurement rules to drive up standards and encourage sustainable, inclusive growth. To achieve that, the lowest cost only option needs to be the exception to the rule, and social, economic and environmental criteria must become the norm. New legislation alone is not enough. The Commission is failing to make sure that public authorities make full use of this legislation. I have asked the Commission to confirm that EU rules did not oblige the UK Government to make the choice that it did, and they have failed to reply to me, although the deadline for a response was over 2 weeks ago. The Commission must do more to make public authorities aware of the full extent of what they can do under EU legislation.
Thank you, Mrs. Willmott. Mr. Kelly.
Thank you again, President. We had a healthy debate on this subject last night, and then I asked a question of the Commissioner. I